Hey everyone, and welcome back to Shady Side Library. So you already know, before we get started, I've got to show you some bookmarks because Valentine's Day is right around the corner, and I know your loved one wants some special bookmarks because you love them. And remember, these are all custom. I can do any color, any design. I can do like a spooky design. I can do anything like that. I'm gonna show this one up close. I really like this one. It's just got like uplifting messages on it and stuff like that. I hope that wasn't backwards. Let's see if that'll show. But just some positivity. I love the positivity. I'm all about the positive vibes. You got some Disney ones. You got some flowery ones. More flowery ones. You got some pink polka dots, just because Valentine's Day. And then, of course, I've got the spooky ones. So I've still got everything. I can still do Goosebumps, Fear Street, all that fun stuff. I just figured I'd show you guys my little repertoire. But yeah, I've got all these, $3 each. I'll get them shipped out. I'll get them to you before Valentine's Day so you can get them to your significant other. Or just your loved one. Because it's not all about significant others. You don't have to be in a relationship. Okay. Enough about the bookmarks. Thank you guys for buying. Anyways, today I wanted to talk about an interesting topic that is going to involve you guys. So I need your participation in the comments because I want everyone's opinion on this. We are going to be comparing vintage YA horror, such as Fear Street, and Christopher Pike, and we're going to be comparing it with modern day YA horror. And my best example is going to have to be Clown in a Cornfield and Clown in a Cornfield 2, because these are published novels. You're probably like, oh, what about Cameron Chaney's book? And well, Cameron Chaney's book is phenomenal, but it's self-published. So a self-published book, you can kind of do whatever you want with it. From what I know of, I think you can write whatever you want. Plus, this is kind of like an homage to Fear Street, Point Horror, and so he's throwing it back. And so it's a little different. He's trying to mimic a vintage YA horror book. Whereas Clown in a Cornfield actually is a modern day YA horror book. I mean, with cell phones and, you know, FaceTime and all the modern day elements. I mean, they talk about TikTok. They talk about all the stuff going on, so it's completely different, and I really want to get y'all's opinion on it, and mostly because I just finished reading Clown in a Cornfield 2, and I loved it. I mean, this is my, I think, third five-star read of 2024, so I don't know, I'm loving it, but I liked the sequel better than the original. But let's talk about it real quick. So I will mention a few other books as well, but my main thing is going to be the fact that I like how vintage YA horror used to be able to cross a lot of boundaries and without upsetting people. For example, I believe it's in the wrong number, but there's a prank call in which you can't do in the newer books. It's it just doesn't work like that anymore because of cell phones and everything. So I like that there's no social media in these, there's no cell phones, and there's you can get away with a lot more. And this in the stories are honestly more scary in my opinion. But I believe there's like a bomb threat in the wrong number. And I mean, you could never pass writing a book that involves a bomb threat in nowadays. I mean, it's just people will think you're out to do bad things or, you know, become a terrorist or I don't know. People are a lot more sensitive because unfortunately a lot of this stuff is really happening. But, you know, they used to write about it and it used to be entertaining because it's really scary. But now it's actually happening, so that's no fun. But I do like the edginess of these books, especially Christopher Pike. I mean, this man crossed all the boundaries. I mean, there are a lot of trigger warnings in his books, and there's things he writes about that can't be written about nowadays because people get offended. And I like reading the vintage stuff because a lot of it is kind of offensive and a little over the crosses the boundary a little bit, and I like that, you know? It's edgy and it's fun to read and it's scary. Whereas with the newer books, I think you have to be really careful, especially with you know, like getting published. Like this is published by HarperTeen, and I think you can't cross a lot of these boundaries or talk about certain subjects because they bother people and they're offensive now because 30 years later, I mean, the world has changed, and you know, things that used to not be a big deal are like a big deal nowadays. And yeah, that's tough, you know, it makes these books hard to make scary. But I will say, Adam Caesar does a really good job. And sometimes after reading a book like this, I'm surprised he was able to get published because this one gets very bloody and gory and has a lot of, you know, of profanity in it, which I thought was interesting. He uses a lot of profanity in this one. I liked the sequel a lot better for some reason. I don't know why, but this is the best example, in my opinion, of modern YA horror that's actually good. That's published. So, y'all will have to let me know if there's any other authors writing YA horror because that's another thing. There's no one doing it anymore because it's not really sought after. I mean, people want different kind of stories. I guess probably more wholesome things because of all the terrible things going on in the world. One other thing I wanted to mention that I thought was cool about the newer YA horror books is they're able to explore things that used to not be accepted, like LGBTQ plus characters. This book involves them, and the sequel actually follows two gay kids, and I thought that's really cool. And you absolutely could not do that in a Fear Street book or a Christopher Pike book. Christopher Pike did dabble with it a little bit, but not nearly as much as, like, you know, Clown in a Cornfield 2, where they literally, you know, follow two gay kids and they're like the main characters. So, which I thought was really cool because it you know, makes it feel more realistic, you know? But I want to know what you guys prefer. Do you prefer the older stuff because you could get away with more? Or do you prefer the newer things? I don't know. I like both. I think Adam Caesar does it as best as you can, you know, as far as modern YA horror goes. But I do feel like there's tons of limitations. You have to be really careful without stepping on boundaries because people will get upset and complain. And so, yeah, I just feel like you have to be more careful nowadays, but there are some advantages as well. So, what are y'all's thoughts? Drop them down in the comments. Let me know if there's anyone else writing modern YA horror. The only other author I could think of that is potentially YA horror is K.R. Alexander, and I have not read any of K.R. Alexander's books, but I have this one. I have a few, actually. And I'm talking YA, so I know there are plenty of middle grade kind of horror series that are still being written right now, but I want YA, you know, something comparable to Fear Street or Christopher Pike or Point Horror. And I think this is the closest you'll get besides Clown in a Cornfield. I'm still not sure. This could be middle grade. I haven't read it. This does seem a little juvenile. And honestly, I feel like if anyone tried to write YA horror nowadays, I feel like it would just have to be juvenile because people would be offensive or people would be offended by all the killing and stuff, which is, again, a shocker as to how well Clown in a Cornfield did. I mean, you can't go to a Barnes & Noble without seeing this book, so that's really cool, you know? You know, a published YA horror book that actually has some good slashing in it. I will say, if you're in the mood for a slasher, this one does some slashing. And then go read the sequel, because it was even better. And there's a third book coming out in the series that this year that I'm really excited about. So, those are kind of my rambling thoughts on YA horror, vintage YA horror, versus modern day YA horror, which is going to be stuff like this. One last thing, I know I keep saying that, but I will say the covers of these are just iconic, and I love the covers of YA horror books. I feel like they're way better than the cover art nowadays. But again, this is killer. This is really good. This is some crazy good cover art. So I'll give you that one. But not all of them are like that, you know. I don't know. The vintage covers are my favorite. And of course, this is killer as well. So, sorry, Cameron, for not talking about your book as much. I just wanted to talk about the published stuff because it's hard to get published. That's another aspect, is if you write a YA horror book, no one's going to want to publish it because it's offensive. It crosses all these boundaries. All right, I'm done. The rant is over. Which one do I prefer? You guys know me. I like the vintage stuff. That's why I'm surrounded by it. That's why I collect it. But I'm not opposed to the newer day stuff. I just don't like when they constantly you're talking about cell phones and FaceTime and you can't do prank calls, you can't do this. I mean, I don't know. But there are advantages to both, and which I tried to cover. So let me know in the comments which ones you guys prefer, if you have any recommendations, or if you're still reading YA horror, or if you've had any good 5-star reads lately. Thanks for watching, and I will see you on the next one. Peace.